So Prison Break is still good. I'm still enjoying it. But it got to this point where it was sort of building up, you know? Because I mentioned the whole premise to the show is that the guy gets himself thrown in jail so that he can break out and take his brother with him. And then, you know, things go wrong and all bunch of stuff. And it's building up to this big old thing because his brother is going to get executed. And they, the deadline is there, and they're trying to, you know, they're building it up, and then it fails, and then it gets extended, and then it's weird because it feels like what they're doing is they're just, like, lengthening the climax, and then it just, like, slows down, and now it's just more things, and there are more episodes, and it's still good, and there's still a lot happening, but it was so weird to just go through that, where it was just like, oh shit, this is the thing when it's happening. Ooh, just kidding. And then I think about it, and I think this show has 4 seasons. So 3 more seasons. This one, I checked 22 episodes, then 22 episodes, then I think 13. I think the third season has a lot less, and then the fourth season, again, 22 episodes. But it's all based around this one premise. And there's a lot of shit going on, but I'm just like, how the fuck do you get 4 seasons out of this? And I mean, I'm excited because I'm enjoying myself and it's still a great goddamn show. But it's still weird to be like, you know, they're in prison and they're trying to break out and all of this bad shit's happening. And it's like, okay, this thing's out, so now we have to do this other thing. And eventually they're going to run out of ways or they're going to get caught or something's going to happen. I don't even know what's going to happen. But no, it's a good show. Shout out to my boy Wentworth Miller. So that's what I was doing today. Did I say I would record S.H.I.E.L.D.? Because I didn't. I also didn't do a one and done specifically because all I've been doing is watching Prison Break. Whoops. I should get around to that. There's nothing in my mind where I'm like, oh gosh, I super need to do that one. Well, there is, Katawa Shoujo, or Kawara, I think it's Katawa, whatever, KS, we'll call it KS, there's that, and I made a Twitter post about this. I don't know if anybody read that or understood it, but it was, we mentioned that KS, the download for it was just destroying me with ads, and I was not having that, and then the decision there was, if I do this, I do one that I pay for or one that I've already played. And Dave says, don't do the one that you've already played because apparently he just really doesn't like the mobile version of If My Heart Had Wings. I was cool with it. I don't know. He said something about it, bad or something. I don't fucking remember. But he said not to do that. And then also, I don't want to pay $3 for the other thing, so I should probably just download an older version of KS, which apparently doesn't destroy me with ads, I think. But I think Dave said he would try to get it for me. I don't know. Apparently his computer has a virus now, and he's trying to deal with that, and that's why there's no Kumo or S.H.I.E.L.D. And he should have done that last night, but we were doing something else. let's not dwell on that too much, but, yeah, so, of all, Katawa Shoujo may happen eventually, probably. Dave said, like, you know, he was fine with doing the editing and things for that, but now he needs to get his computer, in proper working condition, so, you know, no idea when that'll happen. I mean, he said he was, like, scanning it, so hopefully it'll just be like, oh, here's your problem, now it's fixed. I don't know if he's got any real good fucking software for that shit. I hope he does. I know I never did. I just kind of gave up, you know? I was just like, oh, there's viruses? That sounds good to me. My computer's fucked. I just ruin it, and then I reset everything, and then, like, wipe the hard drive almost. And then I start from there, and that's why my computer is really, really bad, because I don't take good care of computers. oops. If I get Mike to, like, find me or build me, like, the best computer he can for my terrible low budget, and then I just absolutely destroy it within a month, he's going to be upset. But, you know, God fucking damn it, Santa Claus. All right, whatever. Can we still... I think we can still reach nines. We can at least get close, right? Probably. You know, we have the 50% automatic shit or whatever. That's out, right? Yeah, okay. So we'll see. Let's fucking actually deal some damage, please. the longer it takes to do this, the more chances of a burst we have on the center one. But no, freezing a whole bunch is good. I believe that we're out of freezes now. And we do reach nines. None of these other ones reaching nines is a big deal. Also, I feel like that's kind of loud, but I don't know. I feel like just my brain is fucking with me right now. Gosh, I am a little tired. I'm recording a bit late. But I'm also just tired because I just stayed up really late last night. And then I woke up at like 9. God, I feel like I went to sleep at like 3, which I guess isn't that bad. It's just not what I'm used to. And also what I've been doing all day is just lying down and watching fucking Prison Break. So it's not like I'm a big bursting ball of energy. I'm recording at 9:30 actually. I don't know why I just stopped saying it, but now I'm cool with saying it. But, I'm recording at 9:30 just because... Oh, God damn it! But just because that's what happened. That God damn it was because of the fucking... oh my God, really? This shit? Come on! That should... Yeah. It's so... God damn fucking... We're fine. We're still doing nines. And we're gonna get a lot of the freezes... Not all of the freezes. And you're really gonna fucking do that? Okay, she's out because we fucking wasted one. And you're gonna jump to her instead of... Whatever. It'll at least be 3, you know? It'll at least be 3. I mean, I would like to, but that just all depends on, a couple things. I guess we got Letta's heal already, so that's out. Can we check that? We didn't get her heal. I felt like we took a... Oh, no, we healed from bursting a whole bunch, which is great. But, ooh, she buffed herself, which is bad. Please hit Letta. Please hit Letta. Please hit Letta. Shit. Oh, my God. Seriously? I don't think we would have done very well even if we had healed at an opportune moment. Just because, I don't know, things... Well, we would have gotten a bit more turns in, but still her buffing herself and then she fucking fielded, so yeah, we'll do it in 3, you know. Oh my God, with the goddamn subordinate having that fucking nova. I need to do Letta first. I need to remember to do Letta first. It's always gotta be Letta first, because that means we can give everybody defense. We didn't even get 3, did we? Okay, there we go. And then everybody having defense is a good thing because that means we stay alive longer. I got a comment asking me for advice or something. Not advice. I don't know. I think they were just like, can you get some tips on how to do well in the game? I don't remember the specific wording of it at all. But I used advice that's good for almost any situation, and that's patience and understanding. and that works a lot well with, you know, relationships and things like that. Patience and understanding is important in relationships. But even, you know, when you're playing a game, it's a sort of almost relationship. You have to have patience. You have to... know to that it takes a long time to get really well if you're not willing to spend a lot of money, but you also need to have some idea of how the game works. You know, it's all like, I don't know, like, I can't give you too many tips. I mean, you can look at demonstrations and things, you know, look at Sonata usually shows what his teams are before he just destroys shit with it, and you can just sort of think, you know. Look at your situation, look at your maidens, and think, you know, what
will happen if I put this maiden with this maiden? Will this maiden... This maiden, okay, she has a lot of attack, but her skill is garbage. And, you know, sometimes you don't even know how good a skill is. And then it's more thinking, you know? How useful is it? How often does it happen? And does it help with other maidens? You have to compare these things. You have to look into it. You have to know what you're doing, I guess. You can't just half-ass it. And... I mean, yeah, that's where most of the strategy in this game comes from, if I can call it that. This is not a massively difficult game. And it really is just that. It's really just waiting for the good cards to come around, for good opportunities, maybe good summons if you're spending money, maybe not, maybe just good event cards. Like, this is a great event. This is a great event with a lot of great maidens. So then there's your patience, and then your understanding is just, you know, you need to be able to look at those maidens and say, okay, this will work for my team, or this won't work for my team, or this is what I'll go for, this is where I'll use my jewels, or this is where I'll use my, my rods, or not rods, swords, things like that. And it's really that, you know? It's like, how do you get good at anything? You just get good. you need to just understand a lot of it. And I don't know. I've never been one for being really good at explaining how to do things better. Besides, just sort of, I don't know. I don't when I teach people how to do things, I don't show them exactly what to do every step of the way, and I don't, like in a math class, somebody asks me, hey, Zeke, how do you do this part? I don't get this part. I look at it, and, you know, some people would just be like, oh, the answer's 3, or the answer's 4, you just gotta multiply those. And instead I look at it, and I think back, and I think about the lesson that, the teacher had gave, and then I say, okay, do you remember when the teacher did this thing? You know? And they go, well, not really, I wasn't paying attention. And I go, okay. Well, what they did is actually pretty cool. What they did is they took this and they made it this. And I can't think of any examples right now because it's been a damn long time since I've been in a math class. But, you know, something like that, you know? And I show them, hey, you know, this part here becomes this when you do this. You know, imagine I have a pen and I'm pointing to paper with numbers on it, then everything makes sense. But, you know, and then they go, why? They go, why? And then I can tell them why, you know, because I paid attention to the lesson and perhaps, you know, prior knowledge may come in handy. But I tell them why, and I tell them this is actually because of this other thing. And then I can do that. And then they're like, holy shit, okay, cool. So then I just do this part. And then I'm like, yes, that's exactly it. It's as simple as that. All you had to do was just do that part. And you know how you know that? Because the teacher taught it to you earlier. You know? And it's always as simple as that. So it's just a matter of paying attention and, you know, just knowing what you're doing. And that you know, that goes for math and that goes for games, that goes for almost anything, you know? One of the best things you can do to get better at school and you know, be smarter in general is to learn how to learn, you know? And that's a really weird thing to say, you know, how do I learn how to learn? Well, you can practice. You can practice. I made something up the other day, but I didn't put it into practice. And I want to, because I was talking to somebody and I was just telling them, you know, like I was gloating a little bit. I was telling them about how good my memory is, just because they were saying how bad theirs was. And I was just like, you know, you can train that kind of thing. You can get your memory better, and that's true. You know, there are tons of little mini games. Like the goddamn motherfucking what's it called? The Brain Age concentration training for the DS and shit. They got it from all of them. Those games are fucking fantastic. I own one of them, and I should play it way more often because they're really well made, and all the things are really helpful. And it's like, you know, it's challenging. It's interesting and it's challenging, and you know, it builds on itself, and it's just cool. But you know, they asked, you know, how do you do that? And I think I was a little pressed for time, and I didn't really want to explain very much, so I just said like in a simple word. I think I just said practice, and I was just hoping, you know, they would get the message from that, or they would at least ask me to elaborate. But they haven't talked to me at all since then. But just thinking about it later on, I thought up a little fun thing. That I want to start doing is I want to take a deck of cards, and I want to take a card, and I want to look at the card, and I want to put it down, face down, somewhere in the house. And then I want to get on, do my business, and then at the end of the day, I want to go around, I want to find this card. I want to find every card that I've put down. I'll start with one, maybe two or three. And I want to look at that card. And I want to remember exactly what it is, having looked at it in the morning, and then at night, and then just know by location, and just by doing it, and if I can do that with, you know, five or six or even a whole deck would be outstanding. If someone can just put down cards, an entire deck of cards in various random places, and know exactly what cards they were, that would be really fantastic. And that's great, but that's memory and things. But also, I was talking about learning, and learning really is a lot of paying attention and just being able to understand information and fun ways to do that, or just to, you know, make connections to things and things like that. It's weird to talk about, you know, how your brain works and stuff. That's a bit of psychology, and I refuse to talk about psychology. I love psychology, but I don't know enough about it to really get too much into it. But I mean, what I'm getting into is more how my brain works and how I understand things, and not everyone is me, and I understand that, but I think it's just best to try to understand yourself better. You know, look at yourself, look at what you know you can do and how you know you do things, and the more you think, the better you get at thinking. You know, because it's a skill and you can practice it. It's like a sport. Your brain is a muscle. You may have heard people say that, but it's true. The more you use it, the better it gets. The more your understanding of simple things, the more your understanding of complex things. When you know all the parts, you know the whole thing. And it's a fucking fantastic machine, the brain, because it can do a lot of things, and there's a lot of things it can't do too, and there we have to take shortcuts, and some of those shortcuts are pretty exploitable, and that's where, you know, the linking things comes in, because my way of thinking is very web-like, net-like. Everything is connected. That's how I can just jump from one thing to another, because little things will remind me of other little things, and then I will just be like, oh yeah, this thing, and everything jumps to here and fro, so everything is a little bit connected. And that actually helps, because I can remember things in small detail, and then just connect it to a bigger thing, and then be able to recall that small detail without having to recall the big thing. You know, it's all connected, so then it's just there. So God, I can't really think of any examples, which is bad, but I don't know. Like, it just happens. It's really hard to talk about this thing just because it just happens so naturally, but conversations and things like that. Conversations, I'm absolutely fantastic at remembering conversations. And that's a great thing for learning, too, is, you know, listening to people.
And understanding, you know, what they're saying, what they're meaning, what they're trying to talk about, things like that. That's great for learning because, I mean, there are so many different little things you can learn just by paying attention, you know? and it's just like, I don't know. Sometimes there's just this weird thing where it's just like, oh, why would I want to be smart? And I really like being smart. I really like being smart, and I mean, like, for pretentious reasons, maybe. I think I just enjoy it. You know, I do enjoy telling people they're wrong, but I also enjoy being right, even in to myself, you know? When I remember something, or when I know something obscure, I just get this sense of joy, this sense of accomplishment, this sense of, wow, you know? I knew this thing. I remembered this thing. I don't even know where I knew this thing from, but I knew it, and I know how to do various things. And because, you know, I'm an observer, I pay attention, and I learn things. I'm a learner, you know. One of my greatest skills is just learning, paying attention, and I don't know, following directions, things like that. So it's just cool. And yes, I've just been saying good things about myself this entire time, but I'm also trying to say that other people can be this way too, you know? Like, I've never done very well in school, just because I don't do the work, and in a lot of the case, I don't do the work because I don't need to do the work, and that's not true for everyone. And there are ways that you can get like that, where you can just remember things, and that's the practice, and that's that learning how to learn, and the more you do it, the better you get at it. I've always been a person to just pay attention, and I learn things, and then I just have them, and then I know them, and then everything goes well. It's also a lot in the ears. My ears are always listening, they're always taking in information, and I'm always, you know, like, I'm talking to myself a little bit, talking to myself in my head, too, all the time, just like, oh yeah, this happened. A lot of the time, you'll see a thing in movies where people will go through conversation and events in their heads, and they're like, oh, this is how I want this thing to go, and then it's like, oh, that doesn't actually happen. I do that all the goddamn time. I do that all the time. I think about conversations and things and just talk to people in my head. I just talk to various people. They're just people that I know. I'm just like, oh, this is a legitimate conversation that I could have if I wanted to. Maybe just sometimes, like, I try to approximate what they might say, or I just put in my own words of an interesting conversation that I would like to have, and I don't know, I'm not entirely sure what it achieves, but I like doing it, you know? It's a little crazy, but, you know, it's just a little kind of, I don't know, like, it's my substitution for real conversation, perhaps. But it's also an interesting mental exercise to just, you know, have a mental conversation with another person. It almost creates two people in your head, and they both have their own ideas, and you can argue with yourself in your head, and if you can contain it and you can understand it, if you can argue with yourself, you're not insane. You're actually a little brilliant. If you can contain it and you can do it well and you can understand both sides of the argument until you can come to a legitimate conclusion, that's actually a bit of brilliance, because that's your brain taking two completely polarizing sides of something and fully taking them in and then understanding them and being able to look at both sides and, I don't know, it's just cool. The brain is cool. My brain is cool. Everybody's brain is cool, though. This has been a lot of boasting and saying how awesome I am. But I do want to start doing that card thing. I should start doing that, you know, every day, things like that. Because then it's... Yeah, that's cool. That's actually just a really smart thing I should do. That idea of mine was fantastic. I'm really smart, aren't I? All I've been saying is that I am really smart. I haven't proved it all. I've just said these various things. I've said that I can do them. I haven't proved that I can. And I'm not sure how I could prove a handful of these things. But You know, even talk is good enough to inspire. You know, if I can inspire a bit of creative learning in people to be able to learn. Because our greatest tool as a species is consciousness. Being able to understand. You may think it's hands, thumbs, opposable thumbs. Hey, monkeys have thumbs. Monkeys can do simple tasks. But do monkeys think? Do monkeys think about themselves? Do monkeys understand that they are monkeys? You know, I think, therefore I am. I'm conscious. I am a living being, and I have some sort of understanding of myself. I have a sort of presence. I know that I have a brain because my brain thinks, and my brain has these thoughts, and I can have these thoughts inside my brain. I can have four or five people just having a little conversation. Okay, four or five is actually a bit too much. It's usually a back and forth. Now that I think, I could try to fit like a third in there and give that a full sort of full outlook on the situation. But yeah, that's what a lot of my dreams are too. Because a lot of my thoughts are in conversation. A lot of my dreams are in conversation. It's just me and just talking to people. That's all it is. That's all it always is. My dreams are very simple. Because my brain is very simple. That's how I think. I think in conversation. I know things because I heard other people say them. That's all there is to it. Because I remembered what people said, and that's where I know my knowledge. And a lot of the time, I can remember where I heard these things, where I learned these things. Sometimes I can't. Eventually, it just becomes general knowledge, and the source of it becomes irrelevant, and my brain will just forget it. But there is one that's been rattling around in my head, and that's shepherd's pie, because my brother always makes shepherd's pie, and I'm pretty sure he does it with beef instead of mutton. And mutton is sheep, so shepherd's pie would be mutton. But I saw a Gordon Ramsay video the other day where he was just, you know, he was eating some shitty food or whatever, and he ordered the shepherd's pie, and then he was, you know, like, what is this? And she said, oh, it's beef. And he's like, that's a cottage pie. And then that was it. And that was it. But just from that simple conversation, I now understand, hey, a shepherd's pie with beef instead of mutton, it's called a cottage pie. So next time I see my brother making shepherd's pie, I'm going to ask him, hey, is that beef or mutton? And if he says beef, I'm going to say, oh, that's actually called a cottage pie. He makes fantastic shepherd's pie, though, but it's really good shit. I watched him do it once, but I don't remember too much of it. But that's just because I don't pay too much attention to cooking. If I had seen it multiple times, I probably would be able to. But I don't know. I can get some images from the event in my head, but I just really wasn't internalizing the steps of the cooking, just because I don't give too much of a shit about cooking. I like to make pasta. That's what I do. I boil water and I throw pasta in there and I wait until the pasta is good and ready. My sister undercooks pasta. I don't understand why, but she likes pasta undercooked and it's disgusting and there is something wrong with her. But no, I love her. But I don't know, she does that. It's all right, you know. It's weird. It's actually kind of weird. I never like it. It just tastes weird. But yeah. Recently I've been eating a lot of ravioli. Just because we had a big ass bag of ravioli. It was like a family serving or something. So just every now and then, you know, heating that shit up, you know, with some sauce. I tried the... Because what I do, the first time I did it, I made the ravioli. And then I just poured the sauce out of the can, just onto the bowl of ravioli. And I was like, this is weird, because this sauce came straight out of the fridge, and it's cold, but the ravioli is warm, and I was just like, I was just not having it. And then the next time I did it, I sort of figured it out. You know, I poured a bit of the sauce into the bowl first, and then for fun, I poured a bit of salsa. Just a dash of salsa and a little bit of ketchup. Just a little bit of ketchup. And I stirred that around, stuck it in the microwave, 15 seconds to warm it up. And then after I drained the pierogi, or no, the ravioli, the first time it was pierogies, and there's a difference between the two. I think pierogies have, like, potato or something. I prefer pierogies, but we had raviolis recently. I had a bowl of sauce, 15 seconds in the microwave, and then I drained the ravioli, and then I pour the sauce into the pan, and then I mix that around, so that the sauce is, you know, warming up again, and it's really mixing in there. And then I take the ravioli, put it back in the bowl, and eat it from the bowl. And that's, it's good. It's really good like that. And I don't know how much the salsa or the ketchup really changes it. And I don't even know if the ketchup is that necessary. I think the ketchup, I don't know. It just kind of works. It's a little weird putting ketchup in there. But, you know, it's all tomato anyway. It's all tomato. So the ketchup adds just a dash of thickness to it. So that's cool. And it does taste good. But we are out now, so I need to go grocery shopping. And by that, I mean I need to tell my mom that we need that. Or just next time she goes, I'll go with her and then just get that. And I think she's going tomorrow, so hopefully if I'm awake, because we're out of milk, and we're also out of cat food, or I'm running low, and definitely out of litter. So we need to do that as well. So, cat food, cat litter, and pierogies. I almost said ravioli, but I was like, no, fuck that, pierogies. Pierogies are better. maybe, I think we might be out of salsa, too. Maybe some salsa. Because I like a bit of spicy in there. You know, I could throw some, like, pepper or something on there, but that's just weird. I like a bit of salt, a little bit of salsa. But yeah, that's how you make really good ravioli. Just not really. I mean, like, you can make your own sauce. People know how to do that. I don't care. I just throw shit together and tastes good. But, you know, I stopped because I want to end the episode. Take care of yourself.